to all the gurus. Okay, and then we will start the class with Maha Mantra. Okay, you can all recite with me. If you don't know, you listen, and then as you listen along throughout the classes, then you will learn. If you know, please recite with me. Om Agnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Akshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Imate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Okay, I think we are done. Okay, we're all done chanting 11 times. Did you count? Yes. Okay. Very good. Wonderful. So today, Mother, you can mute everybody. Hare Krishna. Okay. Okay. So today we are going to see the letter R. Even yesterday we saw letter R. And what did you learn? You learned about Radha Rani. Okay, so let's see some of the things that start with letter R. We have rabbit, we have rainbow, we have road, we have raspberries, we have refrigerator, we have rocket, we have ring, we have rat, we have rake. And yesterday I think you saw rhinoceros and then some rooster, isn't it? So many things we have with letter R. Okay, now let's see what are we going to see today. Whom are we going to talk about? So today we are going to talk about Lord Ram. Yesterday you learnt about Radharani, isn't it? Now today we are going to see about Lord Ram. Okay, so you know Lord Ram is one of the 10 avatars, right? In Dashavatar we learn about Lord Ram, isn't it? So why does he come? So when Lord comes, there is some purpose, isn't it? So when he came as Krishna, he exhibited so many wonderful pastimes for his devotees and how he killed so many demons, isn't it? When he came as Kurma, what did he do? He helped churning the Mandara mountain, isn't it? So that the devatas could get the nectar. So like that, when Lord Ram came, first thing, yes, he killed the demon Ravana, who had become very proud of his knowledge and who was becoming so arrogant. He was misusing it. Okay. And secondly, he also wanted to establish, you know, and teach everyone how to be an ideal husband, ideal son, ideal king, isn't it? So we cannot be perfect like Lord Ram, but at least we can try to learn, right, as students. Or as children, you can try to listen, you know, to your parents, listen to your teachers, your elders, isn't it? That is what we are going to learn from Lord Ram. Okay. And then let's see about Lord Ram. Okay. So Lord Ram is the son of King Dasharath and Mother Kaushalya. So King Dasharath was the king of Ayodhya and he had three brothers, Lakshman, Bharat and Shatrughna, and his stepmothers were Kaikai and Sumitra. Okay. And then what happened, you know, as he grew, then he had to go learn and then it was time for him to get married. So whom did he marry? He married Mother Sita. But those times when you have to marry before marriage, you know, there are some tasks that you have to perform, you know, to show that, you know, what kind of a prince you are, how you can support your wife, isn't it? The king wouldn't give his daughter away to anybody and everybody. No, the prince has to prove his worth. And how did Lord Ram prove his worth? He was easily able to break the Lord Shiva's bow. And then he married Mother Sita and they came back to Ayodhya. But what happened? You know, when it was time for Lord Ram to become the king, you know, so there was one wicked maid servant, Manthara. What did she do? She tried to manipulate Kaikai and tell her that, you know, if Ram becomes king, your son and yourself, you will have nothing. Bharat and you will be out of this palace. You will get nothing. So, you know, she came and believed into her words, Manthara. And then what happened? She asked for a boon where Lord Ram had to go in exile for 14 years. But being an idle son, what did he do? Lord Ram easily accepted it without any argument, nothing. He just accepted his father's words, his command and instruction. And Lord Ram, along with Mother Sita and Lakshman, they went to the forest. But meanwhile, what had happened in the forest? So once Lord Ram, you know, there was a golden deer running around here and there, and Mother Sita was captivated by it. And she said, I want that golden deer, so please go and get it for me. So Lord Ram had gone. And then, you know, hearing Lord Ram shouted, you know, Sita, Sita, Sita. So then Lakshman, she said, you know, you also have to go and see what happened to Lord Ram, because I think something is wrong. So you have to go. So, but he had to protect Mother Sita. He couldn't just leave her like that, right? Because it is his duty to protect Mother Sita, because Lord Ram was not there. So, but what did he do? He drew a line which she could not cross. And then he went in search of Lord Ram. But there was this wicked plan was orchestrated by Ravan, because he had heard about Mother Sita's beauty from his sister Shurpanakha. So he had come to kidnap her. But when he tried to kidnap Mother Sita, there was this bird, Jatayu, who was actually a friend of King Dashrath. And he had promised that, you know, in the forest, he would always take care of Mother Sita. So when he saw that she was being kidnapped, he immediately fought with Ravan. But he was no match for Ravan. How could he? He was just a simple bird. But Ravan was so powerful, with so many weapons and so many, full of valor. So then what happened? He immediately cut Jatayu's wing. Okay, the vulture was Jatayu. He immediately cut his wing and he killed him. So Jatayu died protecting Mother Sita, to prevent her from being kidnapped. But then what happened next? When Lord Ram and Lakshman, they heard that Mother Sita has been kidnapped, they went in search of her. So when they went in search of her, they came upon Sugriva, the king of monkeys, Sugriva, and then Hanuman, Jambavan, all the monkey army. And then with their help, he set to find her. But they did not know where she was. So they sent Hanuman to look for her. And Hanuman had special power where he could just cross the ocean and fly and look for Mother Sita. So when Hanuman flew and found out that Mother Sita was in Lanka, he immediately returned and told that, she's in Lanka and we have to cross this ocean and we all have to go there. Then what did they do? They started building a bridge in the ocean. But is it easy task? No way. How can they do it? They were trying to use the stones, but it was not easy. The stones, we know, what does it do when you put it in the water? It sinks. But what did they do? They carved Lord Ram's name on each stone, and then the stone started floating. That was the power of, and the power of the names of Lord Ram. So that's how they built a bridge, and then they crossed the ocean, and then they reached Lanka, where there was a fierce battle between Lord Ram and Ravan, and then where he easily defeated and killed the 10-headed demon, Ravan. And then what did he do? After that, he made Vibhishan. Who was Vibhishan? He was brother of Ravan, but he was a great devotee of Lord Ram. Okay, and then he made Vibhishan the king of Lanka, and then rescuing Mother Sita, Lakshman, Ram, and Mother Sita, they went back to Ayodhya. Okay, and when they went back to Ayodhya, all the people of Ayodhya, they become so happy to see them. And then what do they do on this day? This is a special, special day. And that is called Diwali, where they welcome Lord Ram, where we light the lamps, isn't it? One of everybody's favorite festival, I think, because you can dress up nicely, you can burst crackers, you can light your house, you can light lamps, around your house. It's such a wonderful festival. So that is what, that's why we celebrate, because Lord Ram, he was welcomed back and he returned to Ayodhya after rescuing Mother Sita. Okay, now let us see one simple and sweet pastime which happened. This pastime happened when the monkeys and the monkey army, they were trying to build a bridge to go to Lanka to rescue Mother Sita. So we can know that, these monkeys are not ordinary monkeys that we see this time. They are like powerful, full of strength, very huge monkeys who could carry big, big boulders, who could carry big and heavy stones, and they could, even uproot big trees that you can see in the picture. And then they were using all those things to build the bridge. But while building the bridge, there was one small animal, and that you can see in the picture, a squirrel. The squirrel was seeing all these things. And then he said, how can I help Ram, Lord Ram? I am a very great devotee. It's not that very great devotee. He said, I love Lord Ram and I want to help him. How can I do that? Let me see. So he knew he could not lift this heavy boulder. He knew he could not uproot the trees because he's such a small creature. But then he saw there are some small pebbles and rocks which are lying near the water edge. So he said, I can just use these pebbles and stones, whatever small rocks I can get in my hand. And then he was using those small stones and pebbles and he was dropping them in the ocean to build the bridge. But then what happened? He's such a small creature. They are big, huge monkeys. So when Hanuman saw that the squirrel is also trying to help them, he said, "Squirrel, I don't want you to get hurt. I don't want to crush you, you know. So what you can do is you should move out of our way. And also what you're trying to do is it's just causing us more problem and it is delaying us in making the bridge to Lanka. So please, please move out of the way." That's how he spoke to the squirrel. But immediately when Lord Ram heard what had happened, he appeared and he said to Hanuman that the way he was speaking is very disrespectful. Even though he's a small creature, you know, we cannot belittle anyone like that. That's not the way we speak. We have to speak with, you know, with respect, with kindness, isn't it? So he told Hanuman, "See, it does not matter whether it's squirrel or whether it is you or whether it is anybody. Whosoever does any work for me with the proper desire, with love, and with proper motivation, you know, I care for it. It does not matter. I don't see the quantity of work that you do." Also, we know from the shloka, right? Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam, where Krishna says it does not matter whether you offer me leaf, fruit, you know, or you offer me big plate of prasad, big pizza, a lot of fries, lot of vegetables, paneer sabji, it does not matter. As long as you're offering to me with little bit love and devotion, that is all it matters to me. I don't care for the big, big prasadam that you offer. So like that, he was telling Hanuman. And then Hanuman realized, oh, if I'm a true devotee of Lord Ram, you know, I cannot treat other creatures like that, isn't it? Whether it is ant or spider or anybody we see, we cannot try to squash them or we cannot try to harm them. No, we have to treat each living entity equally. So then that is what he realized. And then what happened? They all started working together, you know, in building the bridge. And you can see in the picture how even the squirrel was trying to help and in the making the bridge using the small stones and pebbles that he could carry. So then after they built the bridge, everybody was ready to, you know, all the monkeys, they lined up and they were ready to cross the ocean. But then what happened? The squirrel, how could it go? So there was Lord Ram was on one shoulder of Hanuman. And then the squirrel asked, "Can I please come with you? Can you please carry me on your shoulder?" And then, so Hanuman was very, you know, kind. And he said, "Yes, yes, yes, why not?" And then he just lifted the squirrel and set him on his shoulder. And then they all started crossing the ocean. And then we can see, you know, how the demigods also from the heaven, they started showering bright and brilliant flowers. And then they all sang, saying, "Victory to Lord Ram, victory to Lord Ram." That is all they said, you know. So we can see how Lord treats everybody equally and how he treats everyone with compassion. You know, it does not matter. It's a small creature or it's a big creature. Okay, Lord Sri Ram ki jai. Now, the moral of the story is we should also treat everybody with respect. Okay, if for this example, you know, where you see that if you see any elderly people or anybody, you should not just, you know, just neglect them. No, if you're traveling somewhere in the bus or if you see when you go to doctor's office or anywhere, you see the elderly person is there, there is no place to sit. So we have to give them respect, right? So they should get up and maybe give them a seat to sit. So like that, Lord treats everybody with respect and Lord also treats every living being equally. And as I said, you know, Lord sees the intention, our love and the effort that we put behind the work that we do. It does not matter if you do a big work or if you do a very small work of, you know, it just matters that with what intention that we are offering, you know, our work to the Lord. Okay, so that is the moral of this story. Okay, now I have some question answer, some fill in the blanks here. So maybe we can unmute few of them, Mataji, or I don't know. Mataji? what?
Oh, sir.
One minute, all Mataji.
Okay. Okay. So the first is the Lord had to cross the dash to get to the city of Dash.
The Lord had to cross the ocean to get to the city of Lanka.
Okay, very good. Very good, very nice. Okay, okay. Now second question, okay? The monkey soldiers, they uprooted Dash to build the dash. See, you have the answers here.
Tree coverage.
Yes. They uprooted the trees to build the bridge. All of you are correct. Very nice. Very nice. Okay, third question. Listen, third question. The tiny Dash loved Lord Ram and did his best to help build the bridge. Which teacher are we talking about? Yes. Squirrel. Correct. Correct. Okay. Fourth question. Fourth question is Lord Ram taught Dash to treat the squirrel with Dash. Yes. Yes, that's correct. He taught Hanuman to treat the squirrel with respect. Very nice. Very nice, all of you. Now, we have one more activity here, crossword. How many of you like to do crossword? Do you do crossword? It's a very simple thing I have given here. Yes? Okay. So across is, you see, across is this, the horizontally. And down means you have vertically. Okay. So the first one, you see first one here. So first is place where Lord Ram ruled. Which palace, which city, you can say, not palace, which city?
Ayodhya.
Yes, Ayodhya. Ayodhya. Ayodhya, okay. So Ayodhya we have, but so what is the letter?
A.
Okay, A. L. What is the other letter? Next letter. What is the next one? A-Y-O-D. Yes, H, correct. I heard H.
Above.
Okay. Yes, okay. Now let me see, some participants are raising the hand. Let me Okay, now let me ask somebody, okay? I'll give a chance to somebody to say. Okay, Satvik. Satvik and Harshvita. You want to do the next one? Okay, now. Okay, second is brother of Lord Ram who went to the forest.
Lakshman.
Okay. Okay, can you spell it out for me?
L.
X will not come here. L A K is okay. Somebody, I heard K. L A K. There is no X. I don't have X here. L A K.
S.
Okay, good. H. Okay.
H. H. A.
Okay, Laksh. L A K S H. Very good. Okay, correct. Okay. Very good. Okay, very nice.
Thank you, Mother.
So who wants to go for the third one?
Pranav.
Okay, Pranav, go for the third one. Devotee of Lord Ram.
Hanuman.
Hanuman.
Who's Pranav? Yes.
Hanuman.
Number one. Okay, very nice. Okay, so we will go for the fourth one. Let me see. Fourth is down. Okay. Okay, Keshavi. Fourth one is the place to where, or the place or the city to where the bridge was built.
Lanka.
Yes.
Maybe Mataji, you don't need to feel. You can ask. Maybe it will take.
Okay, because it's taking time, Mataji, to write. You know, it's already okay. Lanka, very good. Okay, fifth. Concert of Lord Ram.
Concert.
Concert of. Concert means who was wife of Lord Ram?
Sita.
Very good. Yeah. S-I-T-A. Okay. Now you can go for the next. Okay. Sixth is the ten head. Mukunda. Go. Mukunda. Go. The sixth is the ten headed demon. Avan. Very good. Very good. Very good. Okay, very good. Ten-headed demon is Ravan. Okay. Okay, then seventh is, listen, seventh. Okay, seventh is brother of Ravan, who was also devotee of Lord Ram.
Vibhishan.
Vibhishan. Very good. Very good. Very good. Okay. Seventh is Vibhishan. Okay. Eighth is. It is the festival which we celebrate by lighting the lamps.
Diwali.
Very good, very good, very nice, very nice. All of you are so expert in the crossword puzzle, isn't it? All of you get 100 points. Very good.
We get 10,000
points. Okay, you can have 10,000 points. Okay. Now we will meet you in the break room.
Hare Krishna, Lakshmi Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Charging this for us. Wow. Kaka Dada.
Are you there, Vinita Mataji?
Yes, Mataji, I started sharing also.
Okay, thank you, Mataji.
Charging the airport. Right.
The kids.
इन्हीं पर आपको ताकत
Right, Hare Krishna, kids. Are you excited to learn about Devanagari language?
Yes.
Awesome. All right, so let's learn this. These are few letters you see on your screen. How the language is written, actually. The way we write A, B, C, D in English, similarly, it has few letters like E, and all those kind of letters in Devanagari language. But let us just talk about a little bit of background of this language. Mataji, next slide. All right, so I'm just going to read it out. Devanagari, which is one of the oldest script from India, and it is used to write languages like Sanskrit and so on, which helps children to read verses or shlokas in Sanskrit. So you know, right? In our Damodar class, we have been learning so many shlokas every single time. A lot of Matajis, Anjana Mataji and other Matajis, are helping us learn new shlokas every single time. And you know, they all are written in Sanskrit language. And Sanskrit language, or Sanskrit, is actually based on the Devanagari language. So it's exact same letters what we use. So you know, when we learn Devanagari language, it is going to help us learn Sanskrit very well. We can read shlokas very well. So it is the base of that. So memorizing Vedic mantras help the brain associated with functions such as short and long-term memories. We all know that, right? We do a lot of mathematical solutions. We do more complicated solution, and our brain works more, and the brain starts working better and better because we are utilizing our brain more and more. Similarly, for Sanskrit language also, or Devanagari language as well, that, you know, there are very, very long words in Devanagari, and they are very, very short words as well, which helps us utilizing our brain in such a way that the brain is constantly working, so it increases the memory. Devanagari is split into vowels and consonants, just like any other language. So it's very easy to learn language. We all have seen it in the past. It's not going to be difficult, so we will just jump right into it. And we're going to start with vowels today. Mataji, next slide. All right, the first letter for today is O. Mataji, are we doing whiteboard?
One second. Mataji, it's better you have a paper pen. You can show it.
Okay. Yeah, right. Okay, so let us use a notepad instead. I don't know, okay, where am I?
How does she?
Right, so kids, okay. Let's see if you can see. Can you see my notepad?
Yes, Mataji.
Okay. So, kids, look at it. When you are watching your screen as well, the presentation we are doing, you see the first letter, which is called A, which we use in place of A in English. So when you are using A in English, in Devanagari, we use A. Okay? So like for example, an Indian name, Aman. You will write A-M-A-N in English. In Devanagari, we would use this A, and then we will use two more letters to complete Aman word. So let's see how we can write letter A. So this particular picture, what we're showing on the screen also is very, very easy to follow. So if you see the first one is like this. It is this half circle, like C, but it's in this direction though, okay? So that is first one. Now second one is another C in the same direction. So we do like this. Good. And then third is going from here, okay? We are starting from this point and we're going straight line. It's a straight line like this. And then we're doing the fourth one, which is again a straight line, but it is vertical. So we draw a vertical straight line. This was horizontal and this is vertical. Do you see that? Pretty easy, right? And then the fifth one The fifth line is going to be a horizontal line on the top of number four. So this was number one, this is two, this was three. This is our fourth one, and we are doing a horizontal line like this, which is number five. Okay, easy, right? Very easy. So you can try practicing it later. You just have to follow these steps and do it. We will probably share these steps in the WhatsApp group as well, so that you can follow that easily. All right, now let us see one example of letter A. Mataji, next slide. All right, here we go. Our favorite horse, right? All kids like horses. So horse is the English word. And then in Devanagari, we call it Ashva. So A is the letter we just talked about. And then we added two more letters to it to make it complete Ashva, which is a horse in English. That is one of the example of letter A. Or in Devanagari language. All right, let's move on to the second letter. Mataji, next slide. All right, so the first one was A, the second one is A. You see, it is not much different from the letter A we just learned. Letter A has everything A letter had. What we're gonna do, just one more thing. We are adding one more step, that is after this vertical line, we're gonna add another vertical line, like just like this. What do you think? Easy? That makes it A. And then as we were using Devanagari letter A for English letter A, similarly, we're gonna use A for AA. So for example, Aarti, right? We offer Aarti to the Lord. So we use A-A-R-T-I. So we are using two A's here. Whenever we're gonna use two A's in Devanagari, we're gonna use A. Pretty simple, right? Yeah, practice this, it's pretty easy. Now let's see an example of A. All right, a mango. Mango is the best example, right? We all love mango. So mango is called letter A, and we are adding another letter to it called M. So it is A-M, which is mango. Don't get confused with all the words we have written here. First is A-M, which is Devanagari language. This is exactly how we write it in the Devanagari language. The second one is A-A-M. It's not Devanagari language, but we have written the same Devanagari language in English. You know, if you have to somehow write it in English, this is how you write it. I mean, if you would have read Gita, Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavatam, you would have seen the shlokas written in English and Devanagari language both, right? So this is how it would appear. Mango is the word in English for sure. All right, awesome. So we learned two letters so far. Let us learn the third letter. And the third letter is E. So first was A, then A, and the third letter is E. Not difficult, right? It's very twisted like jalebi, but it's easy to do. So the first one, you just draw a straight vertical line like this, just like that. Then we're gonna make S shape, right? The way we do it in English. So this is our S shape in English. So that makes it ours. This is number one. First C kind of shape is number two, and second C shape is number three. This is what we did so far. Okay, for the fourth step, we're gonna just do a little bit twist here and bring it down like that. That's it, very simple. Now the last step is, getting the horizontal line just on the top of our vertical line. Wow, that makes it E. Well, it's not very pretty because I'm working in this direction, but it's pretty much same as showing on your screen too. Again, we use E letter. Very simple, right? E, and English also you have E. Sometimes it's used for E, sometimes for I, you know, a little different, but that's how you do it. And the biggest example for this is tamarind. We all like tamarind, right? We use tamarind in sambar, rasam, a lot of Indian food. So tamarind is called imli. That's the example in front of you. Good? Kids, practice that. Now let's move on to the next letter. All right, the next letter, I think this is the last letter for today, is, do you see, so this is E, and do you see what you're what we are showing on the screen has just one difference, and that is we are making C kind of curve on the top of whatever we have written so far. It's pretty much like this, and that's your step number 6. So the difference between the earlier E and this E is only this C kind of shape on the top, and the first E we used for a single letter E, but this one with this C on the top we use for double E. That is the only difference. So this is how we have learned the letters, right? And that means two letters. E, E, that's how you pronounce it, right? Short and long, E, E, like that. All right, let's look at the example of this one. Mataji, next slide. Wow, that's such a pretty example of this. This is Ishwar. We have added more letters to it, but your first letter is what we're using here. E is the first letter, and we used a couple of more letters to make it a complete word. Ishwar is God. So God we call in Devanagari language as Ishwar. So kids, do we have more slides, Mataji? I think that's pretty much it. Yeah, I think this is all. Yeah, so this is all, kids, for today. We will keep continuing with these classes more, but just know the difference that there are four letters we learned today. Very simple. A, E, E. And A is A letter. A is A letter. E is E or I letter in English. And E is double E letter in English. It's very straightforward. So yeah, learn how to write these letters as a practice, and try posting that in WhatsApp group and see what you find with these letters. So if you are saying E, so I'm saying that E is Ishwar, which is the Devanagari word for God, then see what other words you find with these letters, these four letters, what we learned today, and post it in the WhatsApp group.
Mataji?
Yes?
What was the meaning of the last word we did, the last word? What?
Are you talking about
letter? So, which two letters were the word in the last word we did?
Are you talking about E?
Yeah, the last one we did.
Yeah, a slide before this, Mataji. The last one was E, which is a longer letter of E. It is used for double E.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. It's time to end, Mataji.
Oh, it's time to end. All right, kids. Yeah, if you have any questions, please post it in the WhatsApp group. We are running late today.
We did the E and other stuff in the other class.
That's awesome. You already know it. All right, kids.
Yeah, it's A, and E.